Hi guys, welcome back to Sarah's Diaries. Thank you all so much for the love and support for my previous videos. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, please press the subscribe button below this video. So it's springtime in Sydney, the most beautiful time of the year. The city is blooming and so is my little veggie patch. There is coriander this year, lettuce, carrots, bitter gourd and a lot more vegetables. But my coriander is overtaking all the other plants. It's gone crazy and it's growing like a weed. So even our neighbors are now bored of coriander. But it adds a nice herb fragrance to my garden when I step in the morning and in the evenings. And I really love it. And it reminds me of a very aromatic coriander pulao my mom used to make. It was a hit among all our guests. And even when I took it for lunch to office, all my friends would love it. It looks very pretty and it tastes amazing. Let me quickly show you how to make it. It's a very simple recipe. Now I'm going to get some coriander straight from the plant. The freshness adds a lot of nutrition and flavor to your dishes. Do try to grow some herbs in your house if you have some time and some space. The ingredients we need for this dish are bay leaf, cinnamon, cardamom and cloves, 1 chopped onion, 1 cup of basmati rice, 1 carrot chopped into pieces. For the green paste we need 10 cashew nuts, 2 pieces of coconut, 3 green chilies, 2 pods of garlic and a whole bunch of coriander. Now we combine all of the ingredients for the green paste into a mixer jar. Heat oil or ghee in a deep bottom dish, add the whole spices and then add the chopped onions and sauté until they are soft. Now we are going to add the green paste and fry it for 2 minutes until it loses all the water and gets a little dry. We are going to add in the carrots and 2 cups of water and bring it to a boil. Add some salt and let the water boil for a few more minutes. Now we add the washed rice into the boiling water. I usually try to avoid using a pressure cooker for making biryani or pulao. I seal the pan with aluminium foil and close it with a tight lid to give it the dum effect. Put it on the stove for 10 to 15 minutes on low flame and let the steam settle down for another 10 minutes before opening the lid. And oh my god, this aroma reminds me so much of my mom. Add a spoon of ghee and mix it thoroughly without breaking the rice. The spices and the coriander combined with the creaminess of the cashew nut and coconut makes this pulao delicious. Serve it with raita and you can thank me for the recipe later.
Thanks for watching guys. Please press on the subscribe button below the video. See you soon. Ta-da.